All right, so hi everyone. Thank you for coming today. This is a meet and greet with the Executive Board of the Online Writing Centers Association, or OWCA. We are so excited you are here today to meet some of our executive board members and learn more about our association. Here is our agenda for the meet and greet. We will give a brief history of the OWCA since we are a new organization, and we will introduce ourselves as the current executive board. Then we're going to talk about what the board and all of our committees have been working on this year and how you can get involved for next year. And then we will open it up for questions and discussion. But please feel free to ask questions at any time in the chat, even while we are presenting. We are happy to answer your questions. And please also enjoy this picture of me wearing a dinosaur head and typing at a computer. So we'll start with a brief introduction for anyone who might not be familiar with our organization. We started out as the Online Writing Centers community in July 2018. At that time, we were just four women who worked in online writing centers and were frustrated by the lack of support for this work in the field at the time. So we started a website, created a database for scholarship on online writing centers, and hosted informal events and discussions to connect people doing this work. We operated as the Online Writing Centers community for a little over 2 years. And then the pandemic happened in 2020, and suddenly there were a lot more writing center people who needed to move online in a hurry and were searching for events and resources and mentoring. So we decided to transition into a professional association so we could better support people in our field moving forward. After months of work, we announced the Online Writing Centers Association in October 2020. The organization will be 1 year old later this month, which is very exciting. And we are now a 501c3 nonprofit professional association with an executive board, committees, and membership. So 2021 has been a very busy first year for the OWCA. We obtained 501c3 status with the IRS in January, thanks to Elle, our treasurer, for all of her hard work on that. We've had over 360 members join since we announced the association last year. In January, we started six long-term committees. We will talk more about each of these committees today and what they've been working on. We released an anti-racism statement with action items for our organization. We planned our first virtual conference, which of course is going on this week. Last month, we revised our bylaws and added six more positions to the executive board, which you'll also learn about today. And we will be holding our first election next month in November 2021. We have many opportunities for you to get involved for 2022. This week, we put out a call for applications for the executive board. We have six openings for a diversity and social justice co-chair, an accessibility co-chair, a virtual events co-chair, a student representative, a website coordinator, and a grant coordinator. And if the executive board is too much of a time commitment for you, you can also just volunteer to be on one of our committees. We have a diversity and social justice committee, accessibility committee, conference committee, virtual events committee, mentoring and resources committee, and liaison committee. We will talk about all of these opportunities in depth in just a bit. But before we do that, we will introduce ourselves as current executive board members. It's important to know who you'll be working with in an organization if you decide to volunteer. I am Janelle Dempsey, and I am the founding president of the OWCA. I have been involved with writing centers for over 11 years at this point, and I've done online writing center work for about 9 years. I started out as an undergraduate writing consultant, then I was a graduate writing consultant, and later a writing center administrator. Currently, I am the Institutional Review Board Coordinator at North Central University, and I've started a fully online writing support program there for the IRB application. This year, I've bounced around between multiple OWCA committees to help out where I needed. Most of my time has been on the Conference Committee and Accessibility Committee. I've also been managing our website along with Elle and Cynthia. It has been a very busy year for me, as you can imagine. So I am really just looking forward to having some fun on Halloween. I've included a photo here of my family on Halloween last year. I am in the blow up T-Rex costume. Mason is wearing the T-Rex head and our dog Jack is in a little T-Rex costume as well. We just moved to a new area and we bought a big inflatable T-Rex skeleton for our front yard. So we're getting excited about being the new dinosaur weirdos on the street. And now I'll turn it over to Sarah.
Thanks, Janelle. That's hard to follow. I am Sarah Prince. I'm the founding vice president for OWCA. I have around 17 years of experience in writing centers. I started out as a writing center tutor as an undergraduate and a writing center fellow at grad school at Emory University in Atlanta. During my time at Emory, I got my PhD in women's studies, but I decided at that point that I really loved writing center work. Knowing this, but still having little other direction, I stumbled upon Walden University and I thought, this is never gonna work. I love face-to-face interaction with students. But I started as a professional writing tutor there just in terms of, you know, I'll stick this out until I find a job in academia that I'm really in love with. And yet here we are 11 years later, and I'm still at Walden as Associate Director of Resource Management for Walden University's Writing Center. So at Walden, at Walden's Writing Center, all of our sessions are online with students. I also head up our writing assessment, our website resources, all of our webinars, our interactive modules, and our synchronous course visits. Walden also has residencies, both online and in person, which are kind of like curriculum intensives, which my department is also responsible for. Finally, I do still teach. I teach writing courses at the undergraduate and graduate levels, including dissertation workshops. I currently am in Peachtree City, Georgia, thus the golf cart at the bottom of my image. There are roughly 90 miles of golf cart paths in Peachtree City. So as someone who works from home, most of my travel is done via golf cart. I actually take my kids to and from school on a golf cart, and it's sort of ridiculous, but it's also really, really convenient. There's no car seats, so that's nice, I guess. I have two boys, Bennett, who is 7, and Grady, who's 4. The newest addition to our family is Farley, who is a miniature schnauzer. That's Farley with a fresh do there. All of those folks keep me really busy. So those are all of my interests at this point. Beth, you want to take it away?
Thanks, Sarah. Hi, all. I am Beth Nastachowski, and I've been working writing centers since I was an undergraduate tutor. I've been at the Walden Writing Center with Sarah for about 11 years now in different roles, and I currently head up the part of our writing center that provides the traditional writing center services you'll often think of, including our paper review appointments, course visits, Q&A, and that sort of thing. I am also a contributing faculty member for our graduate writing courses at my institution as well, which I really enjoy. For OWCA, I am the founding secretary and co-chair of the Mentoring and Resources Committee, and it's really been a pleasure seeing Janelle lead this organization and start it from scratch, as well as work with our great board members and committee members. So really, thank you to all of you. As secretary, I helped Janelle with agendas and taking notes, as well as documenting votes and running our election this fall, which I have to say just was open for applications and nominations. So a quick plug there. And as part of the Mentoring and Resources Committee, I have been working on our committee with our committee members to re-envision our OWCA mentor matching into a group mentoring program. Registration for that is also currently open, so we have had a busy couple of weeks. And I encourage you to check that out. That program is free for all OWCA members. The pictures here are of my two sons, Harrison and Arthur, and our new cat, Jasper, who may or may not jump up behind me randomly during our meet and greet today. They definitely keep me busy. So that's it for me, and I'll hand it over to Elle.
Thanks, Beth. Hello, everyone. I'm Elle Tyson. I'm published under Lisa Nicole Tyson, so you might see that elsewhere in the conference program. I'm the founding treasurer. I've done about 5 to 6 years in writing centers. I've been a professional writing tutor, graduate assistant writing tutor, and I've done some language tutoring in undergrad and as a freelancer. I studied TESOL, teaching English to speakers of other languages. But once I started the first writing tutor job, I was like, oh, okay, that's it. This is what I want to do for the rest of my career. I'm currently the ePortfolio Student Support Coordinator at Old Dominion University in Norfolk, Virginia. So we have a separate university writing center, which you'll actually hear more about in a bit. And then the ePortfolio Studio focuses on digital composition tutoring. We focus more on students' ePortfolios and fostering their digital identity, as well as helping with various digital tools that they're assigned by their instructors. I'm also a PhD student in English at ODU. My research interests related to tutoring are the online tutoring experience for both parties, but especially asynchronous screencasting. And I also look at how students perform identity in their ePortfolios. I'm the co-treasurer of Humanities Behind Bars, which is an abolitionist group here in Norfolk, Virginia. And we do a lot of different things, but we teach in local jails that hopefully will start up again. We kind of had to put that on hold with COVID. But we also have inside-outside reading groups, and we started a rotating community bail fund that I'm also the treasurer of, that's called the Tidewater Solidarity Bail Fund. But so that's kind of my treasurer background and what brought me into this particular role within the OWC community. I'm also a licensed hairstylist, so I always have different colored hair. My dog, Jolly Roger, is a hairless Chinese crested. So he pretty much always has clothing on. He loves wearing clothes. He doesn't really like being naked. So you can see him here in his little unicorn sweater. And then I really like plants. So I do a lot of gardening. I have a lot of house plants, probably too many house plants, but you know, I just keep collecting them and getting more. So that's a bit about me personally, and I will hand it over to you, Paula.
Thanks, Elle. So I'm Paula, and I'm the current Diversity and Social Justice Committee Chair. I've been working in writing centers since my sophomore year of undergrad. I just immediately loved the ability to talk to so many different people about their writing and different subjects and learn from them while also feeling like I was helping them. So I became hooked, and I've worked in writing centers ever since. That includes some time spent at the University of Georgia, where I served as assistant director of the writing center for a bit. I was also an assistant director at the Iowa State Writing and Media Center before my current job, which is assistant director of the Yale College Writing Center. We support Yale's undergraduates and are housed in Yale's Purview Center for Teaching and Learning. Lately, I've been super busy because the staff here is much larger than any I've helped supervise in the past. We have about 113 writing partners here. And we've had our hands full with the transition back to campus this fall, but I'm really excited that we're keeping online writing support available 6 days a week. Even though I am firmly planted in writing centers right now, I still maintain a love of Southern Lit, which was the focus of my PhD studies. So you'll also find me at the Society for the Study of Southern Lit moderating a panel on Carson McCullers in February. When I do find free time, I love going to concerts and comedy shows. I also love watching competition baking shows. My friends and I, including my partner, Wes, who you see here, are currently competing in a fantasy Halloween baking championship league. And I'm, like Janelle, I'm also very excited about Halloween. You can see me and Wes here. I'm a pandemic bride. We got married almost a year ago on 10/20/2020. And that's our dog, Sam, who is currently in doggy boot camp, because he never learned manners, and now we're trying, and he's 7 years old. So wish us luck. And Brooke, I believe you're up next.
I love all the dogs in this presentation. Hi, everybody. I'm so delighted to be part of this panel, because it was just a year ago, attending a session like this on Zoom, that convinced me that I really needed to join OWCA. I could tell the organizers were super focused, super equipped to do concrete, important work, but also like super fun humans. And now a year later, I can report that it is all true. This is such an amazing group. I'm currently chair of the Accessibility Committee, and I sought this role both to learn and to serve. I've been studying and working with Universal Design for Learning as a writing instructor and as a program developer for over 20 years, experimenting with ways to make teaching and learning more accessible online and in other environments too. So about 10 years ago, I began losing my hearing, and that made me even more sensitive. And I'll be honest, more vulnerable as a teacher and as a learner. So it taught me how important it is to stay connected with people and to find mentors who can share new perspectives on how to be an inclusive and accessible teacher, but also to find my own way in communities. So I'm really fortunate to be studying and learning about that, as well as mentoring others. And of course, we are all super privileged to have Janelle's leadership in this organization as an accessibility expert and as a member of our committee. So like many of my colleagues here, I first got involved in online tutoring and writing centers as a graduate student. Then I took a fairly conventional path. I became a full-time professor of rhetoric and composition at Oklahoma City University, where I taught for 14 years and tapped into the Writing and Learning Center there as a teacher, but also was invited to help transform our center from a learning enhancement center into more of a learning commons based in our library. And that experience was really exciting for me, and it inspired me to flip my script professionally. So instead of being mostly a professor who sometimes got involved in tutoring and writing center work, I saw a job where I could do the opposite. So now I do teach writing and digital storytelling at California College of the Arts, but my primary job is as the director of an online hybrid writing and learning center. Fun fact about me is I'm also a novice glassblower. Before the pandemic, I enrolled as an honorary glass major, but as a student in the glass program at CCA. And also, of course, I am a dog lover, and pictured here is Nadja, who I also call Whimsy. And this is her cooling off in a pool during a road trip to Tucson, Arizona. So that's a bit about me. And next, I think Megan is up.
Yep, I think so. Thanks, Brooke. Hi, all. I'm Megan Bozhart-Burrell. I'm the virtual events chair for OWCA. I've worked in writing centers for a little over 10 years now. I began as an undergraduate tutor at The Ohio State University Newark branch. I really enjoyed working there, and for the first time, I felt like I had a clear idea about what I wanted to do with an English degree when I graduated. I continued working in writing centers as a graduate tutor at Texas State University. And my first writing center conference was IWCA in 2012 in San Diego, California. During my time as a grad student at Texas State, I really became interested in tutoring online. And I helped establish Texas State's online tutoring service, which was exciting and fun. I came to Old Dominion University as a PhD student in the fall of 2015. My second year in the program, I actually worked as the associate director in our writing center, and that's actually where I met Al. Currently, I am a full-time lecturer and the writing center director at Old Dominion University, and I'm ABD. So my dissertation is looking at the use of asynchronous screencasting feedback and how students use that feedback during their revision process. My research interests include online tutoring practices, accessibility, student revision processes, and digital composition. As the virtual events chair for OWCA, I work with a committee of folks to plan and host various events. This past year, that's included some pop-up writing center consultation events focused around the conference, as well as a webinar on digital accessibility principles that was given by our president, Janelle. And we're currently working on a reading club that meets every other month and a November webinar, so stay tuned for those things. In my spare time, I like to play video games. I like to play Dungeons and Dragons. I love to play with my dog Zero. You can see him with his little bone in his mouth here. And I like to knit. So the pumpkins that are pictured on my slide are ones that I designed and then knit for my aunt this fall because she turned 70. I think that's about it about me, but I'm also going to introduce a few of our members who can't be here today. Cynthia Pengilly is our website coordinator for OWCA. She's an assistant professor of English and co-director of the technical writing program at Central Washington University. Her research explores rhetoric, technology, and activism with a particular focus on competing representations and articulations of identity in online spaces. She also specializes in digital rhetoric and innovative pedagogical strategies in online writing instruction and online tutoring. Luke Shackelford is one of OWCA's student representatives and is a PhD student at the University of Minnesota Twin Cities. He's a second year PhD student in writing studies with a background in writing center tutoring and administration, and focuses on propaganda, queerness, and rhetoric of health and medicine in multimodality. And he currently serves on our organization's mentorship committee with Beth, and then the diversity and social justice committee with Paula. Last is Anna Shapland, who is also an OWCA student representative. She's a PhD student in children's literature at Illinois State University. She's been involved in Writing Center work since she first became a consultant in her undergraduate career and served as the co-coordinator of Central Michigan University's Online Writing Center as part of her graduate assistantship during her MA. Her particular research interests involve creating collaborative writing spaces focused on purpose-driven and identity-conscious writing, which can more practically customize center resources to an individual writer's needs, personal goals, and past experiences. Also, shout out to Anna, who was the chair of our conference committee and did such a fantastic job. I really don't know how she was able to pull everything together as well as she did, but her and the folks on the conference committee have done an excellent job. And I'm gonna turn it back over to Janelle.
All right, now we will start discussing what our committees have been working on and introducing the open board positions. And we're gonna start with diversity and social justice.
Thanks, Janelle. So as I mentioned earlier, I'm the current chair of the Diversity and Social Justice Committee. I do wanna acknowledge that as a white woman, I'm not always the best face for a diversity and social justice committee, but I definitely welcome and hope that we'll gain some new committee members during this conference. The committee includes five members who meet once a month as a group. The committee projects in 2021 have included helping draft the OWCA's commitment to anti-racism, reviewing the OWCA's bylaws for equity and inclusion, assisting the conference committee in reviewing conference proposals in a fair and unbiased manner, and creating a demographic survey to be distributed among our current OWCA members. Annual projects include attending the OWCA's conference right now and reporting on inclusivity concerns. In the future, we hope to expand the reach of our work within the Writing Center community. And we are excited to be seeking a co-chair who would help out with that possibility. So we're looking for a co-chair who's interested in helping initiate, energize, and lead our engagement in social justice work and human rights advocacy within the Writing Center community. The co-chair will be a voting member of the executive board who, along with the chair of the Diversity and Social Justice Committee, that's me, coordinates tasks and deadlines for the committee. Anyone who possesses a passion for social justice work, including but definitely not limited to anti-racist practice, queer activism, and disability justice, is encouraged to apply. While we value engagement and interest in Writing Center work, our primary requirement is that you're interested in social justice, equity, and community building. And also that you're interested in working with me. And I'd love to meet you and have your help. The Diversity and Social Justice Co-Chair will serve for 1 year and then become the Diversity and Social Justice Chair at the end of my term, which would be in January 2023. I'd really love to have anyone who's interested join our committee or nominate yourself or someone else for the co-chair position. I'm excited to hear what ideas you'll bring and work with you. So let me know if you have any questions that I can help with. Thanks.
Okay, and now we'll talk about accessibility.
So the Accessibility Committee is focused on researching, developing, and supporting best practices that make Online Writing Center work more accessible and inclusive, including the work of our organization, OWCA. So for example, this year we contributed to the various efforts to ensure accessibility principles were built into the virtual conference from the very beginning, from the way the conference was communicated on the website, to the process of inviting people to compose and communicate their questions, concerns, and proposals, and then to mentoring presenters as they develop their materials. And now by observing ways accessibility could be improved next time around. Accessibility is a deep commitment of OWCA at all levels. So our committee's role is often to roll up our sleeves and collaborate on putting resources in place. So after this session, if you click on the Learn tab on the OWCA website, you'll find some great links to scholarship and webinars recommended or authored by our committee members and OWCA members, including a wonderful webinar by Janelle. And if your engagement with the conference sparks interest in doing more with accessibility in your own work, in your own research and teaching, or for the larger community, I hope you'll consider joining us as a volunteer. We also have a co-chair position opening up. And so we're looking for somebody who can take a leadership role as accessibility co-chair to help me organize the committee's work in 2022. And then you would rotate into the accessibility chair position the following year. These roles include joining the executive board, the fabulous group of people on display here today, to help guide our organization and to get a more integrated perspective on the work we're all doing so that we can collaborate as thoughtfully as possible. In terms of the co-chair's role specifically, our committee is looking for people with a strong commitment to accessibility to help us imagine, develop, and complete projects. Our primary interest is in the candidate's perspective and passion for accessibility and for making both the organization and the wider community of online writing centers more accessible. So although we value previous experience with writing center work, we're also extremely open to candidates who are coming to this work from other angles. So we're interested in graduate student scholars who want to make a deep dive into research and praxis in accessibility, as well as people who have engaged with accessibility issues personally and professionally and see the committee as a way to help collaborate for change. We, as you'll see with all the committees, we interact a lot. We try to support each other and develop projects together all the time. So I think, who is next?
I am next.
Ah, great, sorry.
No, it's okay. Now I will talk about our conferences. So the conference committee obviously plans our virtual conferences. This year, they planned our conference going on right now from October 4th to the 8th. The committee wrote the call for proposals, reviewed proposals, and created the conference schedule. They also helped host writing sessions to support people who are writing conference proposals and the people who are creating their presentation materials. And they've also advised on the conference website and are facilitating conference sessions this week. Originally, we were going to put out a call for a conference chair and co-chair for a 2022 conference, but this year has been a really busy one for all of us, and the board has decided to reconsider having an annual conference, at least while we are still a new and small organization. We are thinking about moving to a conference every 2 years to give more time for the committee to prepare and more time for conference presenters to write proposals and create their presentation materials. So we are postponing the call for conference chair and co-chair at this time until we have made a decision on the frequency of our conferences. But we're also curious to know what you think of a conference that happens every 2 years. So please feel free to let us know your thoughts in the chat. And now Megan will talk about virtual events.
Thanks, Janelle. So the OWCA has a committee dedicated to facilitating virtual events focused around online writing center work that we hope to provide the ability for both administrators and tutors to learn and participate in ongoing conversations around online writing centers. So this past year, the virtual events committee has consisted of 3 members, including me as the chair. My fellow committee members are Dwayne Theobald and Jill Dahlman. And if you're interested in participating in our committee, please just feel free to reach out to me. We'd be happy to just have you as a committee member if that's something that you'd like to do. So some of our 2021 events have included pop-up writing center consultation events focused around the conference. So the first one in April 2021 was an event for potential conference presenters to get feedback on their proposals before submitting them. And our second in September 2021 was an event for conference presenters to get feedback on their conference materials with a specific emphasis on helping them ensure that their materials were accessible. So in August 2021, we hosted a webinar on digital accessibility principles presented by Janelle. I know it's come up a couple times, but that's because it was really good. So you can find that on the website. But still upcoming this year is an article club, and we plan to meet every other month and a November webinar. So our intention is to continue holding quarterly webinars. So if you are interested in volunteering to be part of the committee, we would love to hear your ideas for both topics and, you know, potential presenters. On that note, we also currently have an opening. This is for the co-chair for the virtual events committee. This is an elective executive board position for OWCA that lasts for 2 years. The first, you would serve as the co-chair for the committee. In the following year, when I rotate off the board, you would work as the chair of the committee, and you would be working with a new co-chair. So the committee agreed on several things that we're looking for from potential co-chairs for the committee. We're looking for someone who would like to collaborate with us to plan and host the quarterly webinars and also come up with some other unique events. We're really open to new ideas. So we're looking for someone to help our committee make the post-event materials accessible too. So we check the things like transcripts, captions, that sort of thing. And finally, we're interested in having a co-chair that wants to plan events that will include writing center administrators, of course, but also tutors as primary participants. We agreed that we want events to continue to be events that tutors can attend and put that information that they're learning in those webinars into practice while they're tutoring. And I think I'll hand it over to Beth next.
Yeah, thank you so much, Megan. So this year, the Mentoring and Resources Committee has been focused on 2 initiatives, 1, re-envisioning our mentoring program, and 2, reassessing our scholarship archive. So for the mentoring program, as I mentioned before, the committee explored non-hierarchical forms of mentoring, ultimately deciding to develop a group mentoring program that will begin in January of 2022. Registration for those mentoring groups just opened and will be open until the end of November. So you can register between now and the end of November. So I encourage you to check out our mentoring page on the website if you're interested, or reach out if you have any questions. For the Scholarship Archive, my co-chair Luke has been leading discussions in the committee about the best tags we use in the archive and ideas for special collections we can put together. So look out for more of those special collections after the conference. I think we should be able to put something together then. Sarah, I can hand it over to you for the liaison committee.
Yeah, thanks, Beth. We're currently trying to build our liaison committee with members who already have established affiliations with other related organizations. We currently have committee members affiliated with regional IWCA affiliations, including SWCA or the Southeastern Writing Center Association and the Rocky Mountain Writing Center Association. Lisa, I saw you're on the call. So we do have those covered. We also have coverage of some other related organizations, including GSOL and the Online Writing Instruction Community. To be a part of our liaison committee, you don't have to be on the board of another organization. However, we are really in need of members who are already affiliated with regional IWCA organizations and other organizations that I haven't already mentioned. If you are a member of a regional organization or another organization and you think it would make sense for OWCA to partner with that, that organization, I'd love to hear from you. The work requires about 5 hours a month, and it really entails sharing relevant information and possibilities for partnership and collaboration across organizations. Specifically, our hope is that liaison committee members can attend annual conferences or events hosted by their designated affiliation or association or organization, and when possible, act as a liaison between OWCA and that designated association. For example, you might attend your regional IWCA conference and share information with members about OWCA, and then in turn, let us know how OWCA can support or collaborate with that regional organization. Currently, we're working to determine related associations and organizations, secure liaison representation at related associations, plan attendance at upcoming 2022 events, and work on a feasible strategy for liaison work moving forward. So if you are at all interested in participating in liaison committee work, please do send me an email at liaison@writingcenters.org.
At onlinewritingcenters.org.
Oh, sorry, onlinewritingcenters.org. Yes, thank you, Janelle. liaison@onlinewritingcenters.org. I apologize. Okay. And I will now turn it back over to you.
All right, so we have three additional board positions that are open as well that are not really attached to committees necessarily. We have an opening for one student representative. This is a one-year term that starts in January 2022. The position is renewable, so the person in this position could choose to stay on longer than 1 year if they wanted. Student reps are voting members of the executive board as well. The student representative would serve on one committee of their choosing and represent the interests of secondary school, undergraduate, and/or graduate students who are engaged in online writing center work. Outside of their committee work, student representatives can assist other officers with tasks according to their interests and professional goals. So there are opportunities for them to come in with their own ideas or initiatives and work towards them. We also have one opening for a website coordinator. Our website coordinators serve two-year terms, and these terms are also renewable. The website coordinator is also the voting member of the executive board. The website coordinator is responsible for managing the OWCA website, which is a WordPress website. They also manage our membership software, which is Cosmo Labs, Profile Builder, and paid member subscriptions. The person in this position will receive plenty of training on navigating our website and understanding our membership software, and they will also receive training on digital accessibility principles. So you do not need to already know those things before applying. You will receive training. The website coordinator does not need to have Writing Center experience, but they should have some experience with website editing. They should feel comfortable learning the back end of our website and researching answers to website problems. They should also be committed to accessible website content. And again, they will receive training on digital accessibility principles. This person will be working closely with me and Cynthia to learn our website. And now I'll turn it over to Elle to talk about the grant coordinator position.
Sure, thanks, Janelle. So the grants coordinator position will be a bit like the website one. We previously tried having a committee do this work, but we're really looking for someone who has some experience, some expertise in grants. There's one opening for the grants coordinator. It's a 2-year term that will start this January. There'll be a voting member of the executive board. It's not necessary for them to have a lot of experience with writing centers to apply for the position. The grants coordinator would be responsible for researching and finding grant opportunities that fit OWCA's mission, and then writing the grant application to submit it for grants. We're looking for someone who has some experience with grants, especially for nonprofits and professional organizations, but mostly just someone who's committed to getting us some funding through grant opportunities.
All right, so we are hoping that these opportunities sound interesting to some of you, or that you might know someone who would be a good fit. And now we're going to tell you how you can get involved. So of course you can get involved by becoming a member of the OWCA if you haven't already. This meet and greet is open to the public, so we might have some attendees who aren't currently members. We have memberships for students, professionals, and institutions, and we have 1-year, 2-year, and 3-year options. Per our anti-racism statement, we also offer 3-year memberships at no charge for any student or professional who identifies as a person of color, and for any institution that is a minority-serving institution, historically Black college or university, tribal college or university, Hispanic-serving institution, or Asian American and Pacific Islander-serving institution. You can become a member by going to onlinewritingcenters.org/join. You can also attend our conference this week if you're not already. OWCA membership includes access to attend the conference. There are no additional registration fees, processes, or deadlines. So you can become a member today and immediately start watching or attending conference sessions. We have 13 asynchronous sessions that were posted on Monday. We also have 9 synchronous sessions that are scheduled for Thursday and Friday of this week. All synchronous sessions will be recorded, and the recordings will be up through January 2022. You can attend the conference by going to onlinewritingcenters.org/conference. We are also hoping that some of you will want to serve on our executive board and apply for one of the positions we discussed today. You can also nominate someone that you know for a board position. The terms for all open positions will begin in January 2022. If you're interested, you will submit an application on the OWCA website. We accept written statements of 200 to 300 words or video statements that are 2 to 3 minutes long. Applications are due October 31st. You can find full position descriptions and application instructions by going to onlinewritingcenters.org/volunteer/board. And you can also volunteer to serve on one of the committees we discussed today. No application is needed to serve on a committee. You can just email the committee directly to indicate your interest. So to contact a committee, you can find all of their email addresses at onlinewritingcenters.org/volunteer/committee. And now I will turn it over to Sarah to lead our open discussion.
Thanks, Janelle. So I want to open it up to all of you, asking specifically 3 questions, but that doesn't have to limit our discussion. First, what questions do you have about our upcoming projects or committees? I know we threw a lot at you. So if you have any questions, need any additional clarification, do let us know. How could we get you or your center more involved? So if we did not sway you, if one of us didn't sway you with our wit and charm and exciting opportunities, please let us know how we might get you involved. And then finally, what kinds of events or resources would you find helpful to support you next year? And we welcome folks to unmute if you'd like, or you can post your questions in the chat box.
I'm going to be brave and unmute. Can you hear me?
We can. Hi, Lisa. How are you?
Doing well. I just wanted to thank you all. First of all, I can only imagine the amount of work you've put in this year. I'm doubting some of you have even slept. Just thinking through things that would be really neat to see is maybe some informal gatherings or opportunities to kind of chat. I think that there's a lot of innovative work going on in writing centers, in online writing centers right now, and we're kind of up to our elbows in it, so we don't get a chance to talk to each other. But as I've talked to colleagues, there's some really neat things that are happening, new ways of seeing our work, new ways of connecting to writers, as we imagine kind of how to be more accessible, how to meet writers at their points of need. So even asynchronous, you know, which I think in the literature is often relegated to email, we've seen more screencasting research in the last few years, but I think there are even more possibilities that are kind of cropping up, and it'd be neat to just kind of have a brain dump with other people on what we're seeing and where things are going. Anyway, just an idea.
Yeah, that's really useful. I think we always want to make sure, I think we're trying to balance making sure that folks, because we know how valuable time is, making sure that folks have clear and guided direction for discussion. But I appreciate what you're saying, Lisa, which is maybe just having a discussion and seeing where it takes us might be helpful in terms of that innovation component. I think sometimes we don't know what we need until it's in front of us or until we hear about others doing it. So that's helpful. Anyone else? And I apologize if you guys can hear the buzzing in the background.
So I have a question, or I guess it's more of an observation. Sure. So I just wanted to thank everyone who spoke today. This was a lot of great information. And I feel like I know a lot more about how the organization works and what would go into applying potentially for a position. To kind of continue Lisa's point and thinking about maybe lower stakes ways for people to connect, I know that obviously the organization is still new and still kind of gaining its footing, but maybe if there were opportunities for asynchronous connection through the website, more discussion board oriented things that don't involve having to show up for a synchronous session to discuss, but maybe again, like more discussion board oriented or based around maybe a blog post kind of engagement. That might be one way for people to be able to connect with a little bit of a less time commitment at first and maybe kind of get a sense of how to engage with the organization.
Yes, that's a great idea. And we did dip our toes into blog posts initially. Janelle, you'll have to help me recall. But I think that's something in terms of bandwidth we haven't revisited recently, but it's good to know that others are craving that sort of asynchronous engagement. And again, based on time commitments across the board professionally, I can understand why that would be really useful.
Yeah, I mean, we can definitely have, you know, when we get a website coordinator, one thing we can look into is, you know, having a discussion board or something else added to the website that's more asynchronous or even, you know, more informal type of blogging messaging that doesn't even, you know, necessarily require a submission process, perhaps. That's a great idea. Thank you.
I do too. In the chat, people are saying they also really like that discussion board idea. And that does sort of relieve some of the pressure formalized blog posts would require too. So that's a good point.
I'm wondering if that, that's making me wonder about like the W Center listserv and like, is that something that, are people thinking of this as like a repository where you sort of join whatever forum where you're sort of, you know, Oh, that's interesting. I'm just curious about, I see different things popping up in the chat. I was just saying, I'm just sort of curious about different forms that that could take, but it's a half-baked thought.
Yeah, so even looking into like an OWCA Facebook page or something, again, once we have kind of a web coordinator who can kind of take that over our digital presence might be good.
I think that's a great idea. I'm curious for others. Does anyone else maybe engage with that sort of social media presence or even something like Discord or Slack and have gotten traction that way too? I mean, I'm curious about others' experiences too, outside of traditional listservs.
Yeah, I can say, this is Lisa again. I was one of the founding, owners of the Directors of Writing Center's Facebook page. And gave that up about a year ago, just over a year ago, just being overwhelmed with too many things. But when I left, there were like 1,200 people on it and more people signing up each day. So I don't know that we want to recreate that. However, there are times we're having a specific, like this is an online space, could be useful. Sometimes I wonder why IWCA hasn't chosen to do that. To kind of engage those conversations rather than just post announcements, but we could kind of think through the best way to engage.
I was gonna say, Lisa, that was you volunteering to do that for us, but then saying that you stopped because of workload. I didn't get it in fast enough for you, provided that caveat.
I'm not opposed to it. I had just finished up my doctorate and was working two full-time jobs at two different universities. So it was kind of, you know,
a smidge overwhelming. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think those are both great avenues, thinking about more informal ways to engage members and also thinking about sort of lower stakes, asynchronous ways to engage members too, or even attract new membership. Those both make a lot of sense to me. Do other, you know, board members have responses, or does anyone else have questions?
This isn't really a question. It's just thinking about events and resources. And I will say I am on the mentoring committee, and so I'm already really interested in those group voices. But one of the things that I think could be helpful in thinking about events are like panel events, where instead of having a single presenter, there are sort of more. I think at this point, so many of the questions and issues, things that we're troubleshooting are things that like everyone has done in a slightly different way, and getting some of those sort of, multiple sort of angles to get at the same problem could be a really neat way to bring OWC people together.
Yeah, I like that idea too. Brooke says like more of a round table or a lunch and learn scenario. And I think that's true. I'm thinking too, I know even in our virtual conversation hours, we've tried to do similar things where we're kind of addressing particular technologies. And what we've discovered, and it absolutely makes sense, is that a lot of that a lot of the technology and even how the problems are fixed hinges on university context. But I still think those are useful conversations to have. I think we are always working to strike the right balance of making it applicable to enough people, so it's not so specific to a singular university and how they run those pieces, but also thinking through how to make it specific enough so it's relevant. Yes. And as Lisa says, and Megan, I know I've looped you into this conversation now too. In the liaison group, we've talked about partnering with other groups for those kinds of discussions too, which I think is a great idea to sort of help OWCA with bandwidth too, because I think we can broaden our reach when we do partner, and it's a way to build that affiliation.
Right. I think maybe we can, do you want to start wrapping up? All right. Well, thank you all so much for attending today and learning about our organization. Again, we hope that you'll apply for a position on the executive board or volunteer for a committee, or that we'll just get to see you at the synchronous sessions on Thursday and Friday. Thank you all so much. Paula, do you want to go ahead and stop the recording?